from Power Rangers, the movie. Your Prairie League.
Amy, what you wanna do? I think I can stay with you for
right down this road, Johnny Boy from The Outsiders lived. Ralph Macchio.
Excuse me.
hope everyone's having a good day today. Do you know elephants can't jump? Or is it they don't have knees? I'm just kidding. No, I don't think elephants can jump. And then one more. Giraffes have the same amount of vertebrae that we have in their necks. Bases in Oklahoma just where military aircraft land on a daily basis, which is a lot for Oklahoma. I mean, you got, I always call it Whitman for Walt Whitman, but I don't know, white man up in Missouri that has the bombers, and that's, shoot, those bombers could get here to Tulsa in a blink of an eye, you know? Miami Sound Machine Conga. Yeah. God, I would love to dance to this song. Like, with a woman. Second song with the word ghetto in it. Oh, it's over. Damn it. This is Hazel? I'm sure I thought it was Blues Traveler in college or whatever. You see, we could look shit up. We had to go to the computer lab to look shit up, okay? And the people before us had to... It was just word of mouth or what they found at the newspaper or heard. I mean, that's crazy. No wonder we're worried about everything. I just figured out why I can't listen to entire songs. My dad had the same problem. Unless it was you were going through a time where you could hear the same song over and over again. Music's a drug, whether you want to admit it or not. It's probably the most effective drug in the world. As far as manipulating the human spirit. And I mean that manipulation can be positive or negative, and it's all how you look at it in life. But, I don't need to hear the whole song, you know? And by turning it, yes, I might have some crappy songs, but then I listen to more songs a day. Does that make sense? Now, I don't listen to the whole thing, and I don't know the words to them, but it's like I'm getting speed injected into my veins, and I'm feeling great. If I'm really feeling great, I don't think to turn it, but if I want to turn it, you know? And it's you gotta change the drug up. That's why all addictions end up ruining your life, you know? When I was a gambler, you can only, all you're buying is time, you know? I would win $3,000 on a slot machine and then not leave until every penny was gone, and then I was down 300 more charged to my credit card. Okay, I mean, that's how bad it was. You know, in the span of 18 hours. And this is when all of my guns are at the pawn shop, okay? So, you're just buying time, and so that's why I had to finally quit, because it wasn't, you know, that's what I think is so wrong about all these support groups, is they're not addressing the addiction just happens to be what you paired it up with, situational, biological, whatever, but it's, you're avoiding something. It's avoidance of feeling, it's avoidance of you prolong good feelings, you try to subdue bad feelings, all of it is avoidance. Whether it be sex, whatever it is, you're avoiding whatever anxiety is in your life. That's all it is. It's that simple. Some people have it worse than others. Some people are addicted because they're avoiding the anxiety of not, like, gymnasts. Pretty much all athletic, Olympic athletes in traditional sports, most of them have OCD, or they wouldn't ever be able to do that shit. You know, pretty soon your identity as a girl is getting on the U.S. gymnastics team, right? You do things to your body, and what you do in hopes of a gold medal, just so you prove something to yourself and you get admiration, which is a motivator, which I'm motivated. I love praise. Everyone loves praise. But think about all the sacrifices you give, right? Well, it'd be interesting to do interviews of every single ice skater or every